Hello, it's Silja, and today I will do Litmus Day 6. I do know it's Litmus Day 7, but I didn't share my story with literature yesterday, so I will do it today. And even though I like to write, which is the prompt today to read your, some of your writings, I do only write in Norwegian, and I don't think that would be very interesting. I have really enjoyed watching all the videos about your stories with literature. I am behind on making comments, but I will do that with time. But I have really enjoyed them. And I see a lot of similarities. Maybe that is because avid readers do have some kind of similar personalities. I don't know. But I was also like this. I was really shy and a little bit weird or awkward. I was a dreamer growing up, but also really curious. And there are moments that has, I think, has shaped me as the reader I am today, and I will try to talk a little bit about those today. I will start with the beginning. I grew up in a household. And my parents, they were teachers, and I think they had read the same book as I did when I studied to be a teacher, that you have to read a lot to your children. So they made me a member of a book club even before I was born, and they were always reading for me. It was the bedtime stories, but also during the day, and they were both avid readers themselves, and they had this really well-filled bookshelves with a lot of books, and yeah, and I really like to be read to. I love to watch, to look at the pictures and listen to them tell the stories, and I think I really early on catch the connection between the stories they were telling me and the text in the book they were reading from, that it wasn't something they've come up with, it was written somewhere. And I couldn't read, but I really got that connection. And so I was really curious, and I was eager to like start to read by myself. And I remember, like, my dad, he was reading these stories to me in bed, and they were always reading like picture books and fairy tales, and at some point they advanced to like Roald Dahl, Astrid Lindgren and other books. But he was reading to me before bed, and his aim was to get me to go to sleep. And he had this like soothing and calming voice, but at the same time he was a really good teller, so he was living out or acting out the characters, so it was super exciting, and I was really paying attention. And at some point he did realize that this wasn't going to make me sleep, so he was trying another tactic. And he started to read the book slower and slower and more quiet. And he was starting to whisper, and it was so slow and so silent. And he was pretty sure that I was asleep. And then I was, and then what? And then he had to continue on reading with his normal voice. So that didn't work, because I was too invested in the story. when I was 4 years old, I learned to read, and I started to read some on my own. But at the same time, they were continuing on reading to me. And I was reading like picture books, and at some point I advanced to Nancy Drew and books by Enid Blyton. It was mystery books. And also Astrid Lindgren and Roald Dahl by myself. And then on and on. And I was always finding new books in the at the library. And also in my own shelves. My transition into reading more adult books came when I was 11. And it came with a series that I do know now that it was not appropriate to me. And it was a really long series. It was 47 books. And it was a family saga. It started in the 1500s and ended in like 1980s or something. I don't remember. And this was a hybrid of historical fiction, fantasy, and plain and simple smut. And I know the reason why I wanted to read these books was because the main character in like the first 10 books was called Silje. So I felt like this immediate connection to her. So I started to read them. And as I said, it was not appropriate for an 11-year-old to read it. It was meant for adults. But my mother decided to let me read it. And she also read one of the books with me, or she tried and gave up. And I remember she's telling me that, Silje, this is poorly written. And I was like, Because I was already hooked. And she said, and also they're having sex with demons. Do you know that? And I was like, yeah. But she let me continuing on with the series. And I think that has says something about both my mother and my father's philosophy when it comes to reading, that I was allowed to go to their shelves. This book wasn't on their shelves, but in general, I was allowed to go and browse the shelves and pick the books that I was curious about. And they didn't deny me reading any of them. Some of them was too mature for me and I didn't like catch the meaning of it. But at the same time, I was trying. And if it was too difficult, I just put it away. But I think because they didn't deny me any books, that didn't like tell me that you can't read this book, I was able to grow as a reader. I was always challenging myself and I was always on this constant hunt for the next kind of challenge, and I was trying to develop as a reader from a really young age. And also it made me more critical at some point. And I think they wanted me to make my own opinion. And also they knew me that if they had denied me reading a book, I would definitely have picked it up. And one time my dad actually did that. And I, of course, read it. And there are some scenes in the book that I know I shouldn't have read. I should have listened to my dad. But it's like etched into my brain. But it was an experience. And I'm kind of glad that I did. And I am very thankful to my parents that they let me discover for myself what books I enjoyed and what books I didn't enjoy. And let me challenge myself. And I think that is one of the things that has made me the reader I am today. Another thing that happened, it was the last year of junior high. I was 14, 15. And I was reading like this major classic for the first time. It was Peer Gynt by Henrik Ibsen. He was this famous Norwegian playwright. And I was reading that I was reading that play, and I was also reading different interpretations and different essays on that play. And at the same time, I had to figure out my own interpretations. And I think the discovery of reading this primary text and all these secondary texts, and from that make my own opinion about it, made me a more critical reader, or it was like my first step into becoming a more critical reader. And it also was an experience that made me understand that reading things critically was so much fun and interesting. And I think that is also like this big thing that happened in my youth that has made me develop as a reader and to the reader I am now. So yeah, this was a little bit about some of the things that has shaped me as a reader. The reader I am today is a reader that really likes to read things critically. I like classics, I like modern classics, I love the French writers, I read literary fiction, poetry, and I'm dipping out of non-fiction. And I look forward to find more books to discover and to challenge myself, and yeah. I am a reader, and I have always been a reader, and I will always continue to be a reader. And that makes me really happy, because reading is important. So yeah, that was my story with literature, or some highlights. I would really like to hear your story with literature. You can leave them in the comments. And also, if you have some childhood memories regarding reading, I would love to hear them. That's just so interesting. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you tomorrow. Ha det!